Huawei names the cost. The company's founder says the U.S. ban on its products will slash sales by, get this, $30 billion over the next 2 years, and has already led to a 40% drop in overseas handset sales. Cherise Pham joins us live from Shenzhen, China. You know, it's only been 4 weeks that Huawei has been blacklisted. These are some big estimated losses.
These are huge losses, Allison. This is really the starkest terms yet that Huawei has laid out for how this U.S.-led pressure campaign is hurting its bottom line. A $30 billion drop in sales over 2 years, 40% drop in overseas smartphone sales, and let's not forget, a lot of American viewers out there, they may not be very familiar with Huawei because Huawei has been locked out of the U.S. market for the better part of a decade. But our European viewers, you know Huawei very well because that's where Huawei sales have been growing. Almost half of Huawei smartphone sales came from overseas markets last year. Those are markets outside of China. And look, Huawei is the world's number one telecommunications maker, telecommunications equipment maker, and the number two smartphone brand. And Ren Zhengfei said today that he always knew that the company would become a target when it became big, but he said he had no idea that this U.S.-led campaign was coming. Have a listen to what he had to say.
What we didn't foresee was that the U.S. strategic determination to attack us would be so great and could be so unwavering. We also didn't foresee that the U.S. would strategically attack us on so many fronts. However, I don't think this will stop us from moving forward.
He says he doesn't think it will stop the company from moving forward. He's still predicting that the company will survive this these geopolitical headwinds. But of course, this is a massive setback for the company. Washington put Huawei on this trade blacklist about a month ago. It means that U.S. companies can't sell things like software and chips to Huawei. And without access to popular apps like Google Maps and Instagram, Huawei smartphones become a lot less attractive to international consumers. Ren saying the company will survive, but analysts saying if this ban is in it for the long haul, Huawei's global business will really be threatened, Allison.
Yeah, I mean, the company will survive, he says, but how does it go ahead and handle these losses as they go forward? Because Huawei will remain on this blacklist.
Huawei has said that it's been diversifying its supply chain for a while and that they've been stockpiling parts. So they do have some contingency plans in place. They've been trying to build their own operating system for the last little while. So that's something that could replace the Android operating system. And you know, Ren said today, and the numbers bear this out, is that while smartphone sales overseas are on the decline and they've really had this drop since this entity ban came into place, smartphone sales for Huawei are growing in China, and China is one of the biggest markets out there. So they can survive domestically. It will remain to be seen what their global business will look at if this U.S. ban stays in place for much longer.
All right, CNN's Cherise Pham, thanks so much for